Is it supposed to rain today?
I don't know.
But like, that's your whole thing, right?
What are you talking about?
Weather stuff, making forecasts.
Jake, I'm a metrologist, not a meteorologist.
Everything in science and industry, and heck, plenty of things in everyday life, all involve measuring stuff. Metrology is the science of measurement itself. Think about it. Whenever we measure anything, there has to be some kind of system behind it for those measurements to mean anything. Broadly speaking, metrology is that system. Measurement can take many different forms. A more obvious one is dimensional measurement, i.e. length, width, etc. But I'm sure you can easily think of a whole bunch of examples of things that can be measured. We can measure things like electrical current and force. We can measure rotational force, also known as torque. We can measure continuous perpendicular force, or what it's more commonly called, pressure. In fact, there are 9 general categories of measurement officially designated by the International Bureau of Weights and Measures, or BIPM. International Bureau of Weights and Measures? Nah, it's just French. We're talking acoustics, electricity and magnetism, length, mass and stuff related to it, photometry and radiometry, ionizing radiation, time and frequency, thermometry, and chemistry. A lot of important stuff all housed under the umbrella of metrology. And yet, it hardly gets recognized as a science at all. By and large, metrology is looked at simply as a smaller tool within other STEM fields, not as a field all its own. That or just as a box to check off, quality assurance, quality control, etc. And you'll be hard-pressed to find many American colleges or universities that offer metrology as a major. It might be implicitly encompassed within some engineering courses, but that's about it. However, not only is metrology a genuine scientific field, it's an absolutely crucial one. Look at it this way. A car has around 30,000 individual parts, all of which need to work together. For that to be possible, every one of those 30,000 parts needs to be sized correctly, have the right surface texture, reach specific material strength benchmarks, and all within very narrow margins of error. Metrology is how any of that is achieved. Now think about an airplane, which has over 6 million parts, all of which need to fit and function together for that thing to stay together, let alone fly. It's a big ask to handle that big pile of little measurements. And metrology isn't just the process of taking all those measurements. It also includes all the standards and comparisons and layers of certification involved in having any confidence in those measurements in the first place. And that confidence is critical. The outcome of metrology failure can be anything from frustrating to downright catastrophic. And aside from that, literally no other field of science would even work without metrology. How do you collect any kind of data at all without a method of measurement? So yeah, I think it's safe to say it's a real field. They may wear any number of different hats, inspector, CMM operator, QC or QA, but every one of these folks is a metrologist. Maybe you've been a metrologist this whole time and not even realized it. Thanks for watching Metrology Matters, a series aiming to fill the gaps in our overall knowledge of this science of measurement, to give an overview of how it's done, and to explain what it can mean for you. Metrology is the work we do, and metrology is what allows really anyone to do their work too. And it's not the same thing as meteorology.
You get that you can just look the weather up on your phone, right?